Hi friends, welcome back to another full practice Duolingo English test. This practice test I've made for you today consists of all of the current question types that are on the exam. And of course, I will show you the answers after each question so you can check how well you're doing. Taking a practice test like this one is really helpful for you because it will increase your confidence and get you ready for the exam. So let's just jump right into this full test. If you think this type of video is useful for you, do me a favor and write "yes, it is" below in the comments to let me know, and then I'll keep making more practice tests just like this one. Okay, good luck on the test. So you just finished a read and select vocabulary question type. This one comes up between 4 and 6 times on the exam. And I think one of the best ways to prepare for this question type is by using our practice platform on detready.com, where you can practice thousands of questions within the correct time limit, check your answers immediately, and you can use our dictionary function to learn new vocabulary. And of course, all of the other question types on the Duolingo test are also available on this practice platform. So if you're interested, the link is below in the description. Okay, enough from me. Let's get back to this full practice test here on YouTube.
Recycling is a simple way to help protect the environment. Recycling is a simple way to help protect the environment. Recycling is a simple way to help protect the environment. Reading books helps us learn more and see the world in new ways. I'll already be at the movies by the time you make up your mind about what to do. They will have attempted to contact you before the story is released. They will have attempted to contact you before the story is released. they will have attempted to contact you before the story is released. Field research is conducted to verify the mathematical and computer models that are created. Ultimately, the findings of this study were featured in a scientific journal. Ultimately, the findings of this study were featured in a scientific journal. Ultimately, the findings of this study were featured in a scientific journal.
That's a common concern among students. Let's start by exploring your interests and strengths. What subjects have you enjoyed studying the most? That's great. There are many career options available that combine those interests. Networking can be a helpful tool in getting started in any field. You can also gain relevant experience through internships or volunteering. Definitely. You should aim to have a strong academic record, relevant research or work experience, and a well-written personal statement that highlights your goals and why you're a good fit for the program. You'll usually need letters of recommendation from professors, employers, or other professionals who know you well and can speak to your abilities and potential. You should think about who would be best to ask for a recommendation and make sure to give them plenty of notice to write a strong letter.
This photo shows a woman speaking or singing into a microphone in an indoor environment. It's unclear whether she's singing, reciting poetry, or giving a speech. She's holding the microphone in her right hand and using her left hand to steady the cable against the microphone stand's extension. She has curly black hair that falls to her shoulders. Her sleeves are rolled up to the elbows and her brown and white scarf is hanging loose around her neck. To her right, there's a lit candle placed upright on a narrow base. Behind her, there's a large black curtain that suggests she's presenting or performing in front of an audience. His name is Jack. He's had a big impact on my life because he introduced me to a new hobby that I'm now obsessed with. I met him when I first went to university as an undergraduate. The university was hosting a club fair, and I remember as I walked into the hall, this boy ran up to me and asked if I wanted a free chessboard, but the catch was that I had to solve a chess puzzle to win it. I wasn't that interested, but I gave it a go, and actually I completed it easily. I've been really into chess since then. And Jack and I have become very close. Moving on to the next question. At first, our chats were mostly about chess. We discuss some cool strategies and talk about famous chess players.
Yeah.
But now it's not all chess talk. We talk about our future plans and lots of topics. It's always really chill and fun to talk with him. As for the final question, picking in up chess really has done wonders for me. If I've started thinking more strategically, I doubt I'd be this successful in my career if Jack hadn't inspired me to learn chess.
Talk about a teacher who has had a significant impact on your life. What made them special and how did they influence you? Talk about a teacher who has had a significant impact on your life. What made them special and how did they influence you? Talk about a teacher who has had a significant impact on your life. What made them special and how did they influence you?
One teacher in particular comes to mind, Mrs. Smith. She really left a mark on me. She was my English teacher in high school. What was special about her was how she made English fun and engaging. Instead of just reading from textbooks, we had debates, drama performances, and lots of group discussions. She was always very patient and supportive, even when we made mistakes. In fact, she encouraged us to make mistakes as long as we learn from them. It's not just about how she taught English, but also how she cared about us as individuals. She was always there to listen if we had any problems, even if they weren't about English or school. So thanks to Mrs. Smith, I didn't just improve my English skills, but I also learned how to be more confident and express my thoughts better. She honestly made a huge difference in my life, and I would love to have the chance to see her again to let her know that.
Without a shadow of a doubt, the person who's inspired me most in my life is my father. He taught me almost everything I know, from personal parts of life, like how to treat people well, to my academic and professional life. He inspired me every day, and to be honest, I've always wanted to be like him. My dad has many great characteristics, but most importantly, he's a kind and enthusiastic person who loves life and the people around him, and everyone loves him. Well, almost everyone. Of course, he has a few enemies, as we all do. On top of being a good person, he's also very smart. When he was younger, he was one of the pioneers of computer science education in my country. He ran a national campaign for all children to learn basic programming and coding at school, and he even gave free lessons in the evenings. Without a doubt, he's the reason that I'm fascinated by computers and am now pursuing a career in artificial intelligence. To wrap up, my dad has been the biggest inspiration of my life, and I'm still constantly trying to impress him.
Well done, everyone. You just completed a full practice Duolingo test here on YouTube. Was that easy or was it difficult? Let me know below in the comments. One of the most difficult question types on the exam is the write about a photo question type, because you have to describe a photo in just 1 minute. That's not long at all. So in order for you to prepare for that question type, I really recommend you watch this video next, as I cover lots of strategies and give you some good example answers. So I'll see you here.